Hi everyone, we are here at a milestone event for IDRL, IDRL's episode number 10 at BITS Pilani, one of the premier institutes in the country. Today we're going to show you how the pro racetrack is set up for all our viewers online and how the pro pilots are going to traverse this track. So let's start with this start gate. This is our start gate where the pilots are going to cross the first line. Once the drones make it pass through the start gate, we're going to cover the track as follows. So let's follow myself. This is the first turn over here. As we get into the intersection gate, this is our intersection gate, as you see in my backdrop. There is a huge gate that we have built on the top. It's a good size, standard size as we call it at IDRL, about 6 feet clearance. And the drones are going to go right into the top gate like that and through the other side. So yeah, we are covering some of the views for you of this nicely put up element by BITS Pilani. And once they come past through this gate, they go right into this first quadcopters gate. Thank you so much quadcopters again for sponsoring these gates and flags. They have come up really well today, and we also request all our viewers to check out quadcopters.com. They have an excellent selection of quadcopters parts and things like that you can purchase and get into this hobby. So thank you quadcopters. Next is this gate. After they pass through this gate, the turnaround happens like this. We cover this track around this turn around another quadcopter's flag over here, and pretty much a straight pass into that quadcopter's gate. So beautiful weather here, nice sunshine, not too much heat, just the right conditions for drone racing today. Today is our practice day, as we call it, for the pro pilots. Now the drone is going to go through this gate. So we're going to go through the gate with you, with all our viewers. And you can see some cones on the ground also that we have laid up. So this gives a sense of direction to the drones as to what the path is. The drones are going to fly at very high speeds. Tomorrow is going to be our pro race. Today is just the practice day. And here we take another turn around this second quadcopter's flag, a blue one in this case. And as we turn now, you see an eight-shaped element that's right behind me. So this is exactly of the same dimensions as the intersection gate that I told you, but it is just an eight-shaped structure. So it's a much simplified version of the intersection gate. So the drones are going to take off like that. Go right on top of that gate over there. Yeah, you can cover some of the view of that gate. It's a very tall structure. It looks very big, but the thing is, this much size is actually needed for FPV racing, because even with such gates, we have seen pro pilots actually crash into such big gates. So we are providing them with enough clearance so that we can enjoy high speed racing. That's the whole idea. So this is that eight-shaped structure. Once we go past this eight-shaped structure, now we are going right into the second intersection element that's in my backdrop. Again, very nicely put banners by BITS Pilani showing the dates of our event. And Apogee 2018, thank you very much for hosting us. So the drones are going to go again into the top of this gate now, showing you the view, how it looks like. Very big gate, and the drone will come on the other side. So that's our second intersection element, so to speak. And here we're going to take a quick turn. This is a sharp turn over here, so the pilots are going to have to control their drones really well to make this turn happen. And the turn goes like this, another quadcopter's flag that we are hosting over here. And you can see a lot of wind over here, almost bending the flag. Lots of nice wind, nice conditions, beautiful weather. And this is sort of a nice park. Like it's a very well maintained park. And thank you so much Bits for providing this beautiful ground to us. So now we come into this other intersection gate at my backdrop. You see, now the drones are going to come like this below, and they're going to go exactly how I'm going through this gate. So on the other side, and you can see a nice view. You see a nicely aligned view of these two intersection elements. So the drones get a nice turn, smooth turn into this first intersection element that we had shown earlier. Keep in mind, this is the same intersection element that they had covered earlier in the track. So now we are going below this element. And now is the most amazing element that we have built specially for this IDRL 10, and this is kind of a power loop element, split-esque combined. But the idea over here is that the two gates are at an offset length. So the pilots have to make it through the left gate first. They have to come back, and there is a good amount of distance that they have to come back. So once they come back, they have to turn into that right gate that you see. So that's the idea. So let's see how that will work from a more close-up angle. The drone will now cover this portion of the track into this quadcopter's gate. You can see some of the chairs that are lined up over here. This is how we have laid up a barrier, and the drone will come like this. And what will happen is that typically it will power loop, so it will go like that, it will go back. So we are coming back with you into this area of the barrier, and it has to come all the way back, the drone, and it has to go through this particular gate. So that's the genius of this element. Very tough element to master, and we're going to see how the pro pilots are going to make it pass through this particular element. So once this element is done, now we go right into that 8-shaped structure. The same dimensions again as the earlier 8-shaped structure. Very nicely built actually. They are well supported on both sides. You see the kind of metal that is used. It's of good quality and it's very nicely finished. So thank you again, Bits. And the drone will now take from the top of the gate, and it will come on the other side. So once that is done, now we take a kind of a sharp U-turn. These two elements, if you can cover some of the video from here, you can see one of the elements is laid on one side, the other is on the other side. So the drones are going to have to take a proper U-turn like this. And they're going to come to their last element of the track over here. So the last element is this 8-shaped structure now. And the similar logic, they are going to maintain that high altitude to pass this 8-shaped element. Again, you can see the way that it's built, very nicely built, and proper visibility is also there. White visibility is there. So it contrasts to the grass color and it becomes really easy for the pilots. And finally, we come back into this particular area. This we did not cover earlier, but this is actually the launch pad. So you can cover some of the video over here. This is where the drones are going to be kept, and they're going to take off from here. And once they take off from here, they're going to maintain a certain speed to kick off. And they're going to come back to the start gate. as we saw earlier. And at this start gate, we're going to also keep an automated timer. So this timer is going to record all the time lap times of the pilots. We're going to fly two drones at a time over here. So it's going to automatically count those timings. And the idea is to do three laps per heat. We're going to have a set of qualifiers, semis, and finals. So today we're going to give enough time for the pilots to practice on this wonderful track that we have set up for them. And tomorrow we'll see them for the race day. So thank you again for joining us for this another RaceWalk episode at IDRL 10 with Pilani. Thank you so much.